everybody tonight to my senior recital. Everything you'll hear tonight has been written by me, for better or for worse, over the past 4 to 5 years. To welcome you to our concert tonight, I'd like to show you one of my favorite pieces from my early composition days. I was assigned to create a soundtrack for one round of the original computer game, Pong. If you're little in the audience, you might not know what that is, and that's okay, you'll find out. I think I did a pretty great job of capturing the excitement of the game, but I'll let you decide that for yourself. Of the artwork that accompanied this piece. There were three main parts of it. Each artist working on their own part chose to capture something different from Brazil. The Parrot's Fiesta, the piece that accompanies this artwork, is going to be played tonight by Michael Robinson on clarinet, Kayla Payne on flute, Zach Kinnard on guitar, Robert Graham on tambourine, and myself on accordion. Please enjoy. Thank you. Anyone who knows me knows that my first instrument is not accordion, unfortunately, but is piano, an instrument that still holds a dear place in my heart. I attended East Valley Yamaha Music School starting at the age of 6 and always wanted to learn to compose just like I saw the older kids doing. This piece was inspired by Kylie Smith, one of my good friends who wrote my favorite accordion piano piece so far. Featuring Nicholas Turner on piano, here is In the Distance I Hear Dancing. Thank you. musicians. Being told by your professor that your favorite instruments are terrible. Now, I found myself in a very similar situation when faced with the popular joke, welcome to heaven, here's your harp. Welcome to hell, here's your...
Accordion?
What's it, more? Anymore? The most popular answers to this game are banjo, bagpipes, and accordion. So, well, it just so happens that I like the accordion, the banjo, and the bagpipes. So, like any self-respecting musician, what did I do? I wrote a piece for all three of them at the same time. Please enjoy Welcome to Hell, Here's Your, for accordion, bagpipes, and banjo, performed by yours truly. My entire career as a musician is fueled mostly exclusively by spite, the next piece should not come as a surprise to you. Among the many hats I wear, one of them is a classical pianist, so I've had the opportunity to learn lots of music from many different contemporary composers. That being said, I didn't say I have to like all the music that I've ever played. One piece in particular, I hated the ending so much that I just wrote my own piece. The offending piece in question, it was Miguel de Aguilar's Conga. My piece shares no material from his, but the name carries with it my rage. Performed by Sarah Corr on piano, this is La Danza Violenta.
Thank you.
I get so sad about it that my Christmas tree is actually still up. Yes, I know I'm early for Christmas this year.
Yes, I know.
The next piece begins with a funeral for a Christmas tree, turned into a jig, a lullaby, a sea shanty, all rolled into one. Please welcome the saxophone quartet of Bonson Lee, Calvin Wong, Taylor Simpson, and Giovanna Gioscia as they perform my two-movement work titled Jig Macabre.
Thank you.
piece we have for you tonight is actually the oldest piece on the concert, written slightly before my time at ASU. This piece is on the concert tonight so that you can see not only how my style has grown over the years, but you can also see how my style has stayed the same. It's a really big milestone as a composer to be able to look back on your old work and still be proud of it, and I'm happy that I've gotten there, especially for this piece. The lyrics were written by William Mueller, a German poet whom Franz Schubert used the poems of in his song cycles. Featuring Nicholas Turner on piano and Chas Chester's voice, here is Numbness.
Thank you.
unregulated sad time. Now here's some more silly. This next piece, I actually did write the lyrics for, and they're quite funny. I implore you to listen extremely carefully to them, as this train embarks on its journey to Saskatoon, but you'll find the directions are a bit hard to follow. This piece was inspired by Jacob Collier during lockdown, as he did some excerpts he released on Instagram as prompts for composers to respond to. Please welcome Tanner Bayles on tin whistle, Roman Rivera on fiddle, Zach Kinnard on guitar, and Chaz Chester's voice on Train to Saskatoon. graceful and calm second half of the concert tonight. And to kick it off, we've got pieces from a larger set that I'm currently in the process of writing, each of which focuses on a different aspect of piano technique. My hope for when all these pieces are finished is to be able to give them as sets to anyone who is interested, maybe my students or maybe my friends. But for tonight, returning to the stage, we have Nicholas Turner performing three small pieces, A Gray Day, Cloud Nine, and Fluttering. One of these pieces is not like the others, so please listen through all three before applauding Nick. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
play some video games. Being connected to my friends over voice chat, I realized that each of my friends and I have unique talents that would lend themselves to creating our own video game. I started to have some fun creating electronic music and themes for this potential video game. Please take a listen to the title track of this game, Tesseron. Kayla Payne on flute, Zach Kinnard on violin, Robert Graham on tambourine, Sarah Kaur on piano, and myself playing the harp part on the piano as well. Feel free to clap along if you feel so inclined. Thank you. been wearing more recent years is as a jazz pianist. I'm very lucky to have been taking lessons for 3 years so far from our local legend, Raul Yáñez, and this semester adding lessons with ASU graduate student, Alex Izatov. I even got to take jazz composition here at ASU taught by Jeff Lipman, which I thoroughly enjoyed. This next piece is what's known as a contrafact. A contrafact is a piece that takes the chords of an existing jazz piece and creates a new melody. My partner in crime, Jeremiah Sweeney, and I have worked together to contrafact the tune Alice in Wonderland. You may know it from the title theme of the Disney movie. We have turned this into Waltz for Cheshire. concert, and if you find it too much to listen to, please feel free to leave the hall and re-enter when you hear the piece end. Talking to a close friend of mine, they told me about something that they went through and how they felt about it, not quite being able to put the feeling into words. Their words about their experience really stuck with me, and I tried to create a piece that reflected their feelings in a clearer way than they were able to articulate at the time. On solo double bass with accompanying electronics tonight, we have Lauren Burchell playing Stockholm Syndrome. All right, my dear audience, tonight we have seen quite a few different ways and reasons to write and create music, but I think sometimes the most fulfilling pieces are the ones that come from a serene mind. The final piece of our concert is one of these pieces, the Fiesta Lullaby, which was originally written for flute, violin, guitar, and harp, has been amended to be performed here tonight by replacing harp with piano. I hope this final piece lulls to sleep your worries and leaves you feeling calm. This piece features Kayla Payne on flute, Zach Kinnard on guitar, Mohammed Ali Farag on violin, and myself on piano. Here is the Bayles Lullaby.
Thank you.
AV crew, the hall monitors, the composition faculty, my lovely performers, my wonderful family and friends, and the support of viewers like you. Thank you all for attending. Strawberry pie and sandwiches and fruit. Thank you, everyone, and good night. Yay!